I'm David Brewster, and I hail from Halifax, Vermont.
I had never met the painter David Brewster before, but have been familiar with his work for years. His recent show at the Gross McCelaf Gallery in Philadelphia really caught my eye, and the gallery's director, Sharon Ewing, arranged for me to talk to him. I asked him how he got into art.
It was fortunately something I never needed to make a decision about. You know, since I was a very, very small child, I grew up in the country, and I was fairly isolated, and my parents were very active outside the home. Drawing was and sketching was the way I entertained myself. And in particular, I used to spend hours drawing interiors of houses, like looking into a dollhouse. I just loved the drama that takes place in the context of an interior. And it's interesting that I'm saying that as we're looking at this painting of the Vermont State House with this big sweeping grand staircase, which burned from an overheated wood stove in 1857. But I would have similar dramas. They were done in graphite, and I would take the end of the eraser and catch these drawings on fire. The eraser particles would simulate flames, and then I would draw the interior completely charred and burned. And then I would completely erase the whole thing and rebuild it from the cellar up. My buildings always had dry stone foundations with a boiler and a furnace. I mean, things that I had observed in my family's home. I come from a very pastoral upbringing. I grew up in a very pristine, small American farming landscape outside of Baltimore that is a lot like Chad's Ford. And I was, at that time, very influenced by Wyeth. Fortunately or unfortunately, I've had my share of formal art education, including the Pennsylvania Academy and the Maryland Institute College of Art. But in actual fact, my education has always taken place in direct relationship with where I live, with my immediate environment. For example, when I came to Philadelphia to go to UPenn, the graduate program was just a studio space. And I literally, because I'm predominantly an outdoor painter, worked my way from 30th Street Station all the way to the Philadelphia International Airport. In other words, I explored and went in and out of abandoned buildings along the Schuylkill River. So I especially explored the southwest banks of that post-industrial river heritage. It was a gold mine of undisturbed 19th century palaces of industry. It was like an American Venice. It's actually been very recently that I've been able to execute work from start to finish in the studio. Now, up until about 4 years ago, until about the age of 48, I was really orthodox about painting directly from nature. My imagination worked much better when I worked from life. I'm not a copyist, obviously, but when I worked directly from life, it just triggered my imagination. And as a matter of survival, because work was not selling in the galleries, I created these commissions, these historic interpretations for universities, like the Johns Hopkins Carey Business School, based on the life and times of James Carey. It was a real painful transition because I felt claustrophobic. I didn't have the opportunity to walk through fields or investigate a bottle dump or find a projectile point or find some aspect of history that would inform my seeing. But it was a critical opportunity for me to appreciate that I had a vast reservoir of knowledge of nature, an intimate knowledge of nature, and that I could unleash it freely in the studio and trust myself to recreate all these years of communing with nature directly from life. The process is hugely filthy. It's really toxic. I can go through 5 gallons of petroleum distillate, mineral spirits, in a week. The amount of pigment that I waste is really disturbing to me, especially in a time where we're fouling the environment. The technical processes involve the use of my hands, the palm of my hands, a thumb, wide 3-inch China bristle brushes, rags, very, very precise, delicate number two drawing sable brushes, and then paint rollers. Paint rollers has been a very favorite tool of mine that I've incorporated in my work in the last 3 years. I don't go back. They all are actually executed in a period between 2.5 to 4 hours. If it's not unified from top to bottom, from side to side, then I completely wipe it out and do it again. So a lot of these paintings, they are the result of 4 or 5 wipeouts. I can honestly say I'm not a formulaic painter. I am motivated by what I see. Every time I set up to paint, it's a wrestling match with really trying to make as strong of a visual connection as I possibly can with the essentials and bringing to life what I originally saw.
While I was talking to David, I found his passionate intensity about art very exciting. I may have made a bit of a tactical error, though, when I suggested that his landscapes were abstracted.
Well, I was going to say that I think it's glib and a sweeping generalization to refer to my work as abstracted landscapes. To me, my paintings are extremely realistic. That's why I am dogged about refining my vision, and that everything is so perfectly synchronized. I mean, it's been a long road, and I weave in and out of confusion. But when I hit it, I feel that I am conveying a very convincing reality that to me is very legible and very concrete.